The owner of the Alberta trucking company involved in the fatal Humboldt Broncos bus crash has been charged. The Alberta Transportation Minister said Wednesday, October 10, that Sukhmander Singh of Adeshdehol Trucking faces 7 federal charges. 2 counts of failing to maintain logs for drivers' hours of service, 3 counts of failing to monitor the compliance of the driver under safety regulations, and 2 counts of having more than 1 daily log for any day. The 8th charge under provincial regulations alleges failure to have or follow a written safety program. The investigation found multiple instances of non-compliance of various transportation regulatory requirements in a 6-month period. When reached in Calgary, Singh said he didn't have any comment on the charges. The case will be handled by a federal Crown prosecutor because it involves both federal and provincial regulations, according to an Alberta transportation spokesperson. Singh's first court appearance is scheduled for November 9 in Calgary. The maximum penalty for a federal hours of service failing is $5,000 per offense, while the provincial charge carries a $310 penalty. The court can, however, use discretion to impose a penalty up to $2,000. Adeshdehol Trucking has been under suspension since the crash. The incident prompted jurisdictions across Canada to take a closer look at their safety practices. Alberta Transportation was already in the process of considering several improvements to traffic safety in our province. The province said the training, which will include a standardized curriculum, will be mandatory as of March 1, 2019. New requirements for trucking companies based in Alberta will enhance safety on the roads right across the continent. The province will eliminate a temporary safety fitness certificate and require all new commercial carriers to prove compliance with transportation safety regulations before they start operating. They will also be required to renew it every 3 years. Starting March 1, Alberta will require new commercial truck drivers to undergo mandatory entry-level training MELT to obtain a Class 1 or Class 2 license. Drivers who receive one of those two licenses before March 1 will be required to retake the new enhanced test at the government's expense. The announcement comes 8 months after a former Auditor General issued a scathing report that found Alberta Transportation was ignoring its own policy of taking timely and appropriate action against trucking companies that repeatedly flouted the rules. That report was delivered 8 years after the former Auditor General first called out transportation bureaucrats for lax oversight of the industry. In August, a joint 3-day operation involving police from Lethbridge, Calgary, and the Alberta Sheriff's Branch targeted unsafe commercial vehicles and found 134 of 179 vehicles failed to pass an inspection, with 56% immediately placed out of service. The province also plans on closing a glaring loophole that currently allows companies to operate on the roads for 60 days with a temporary safety fitness certificate before meeting safety standards. Those certificates will no longer be available starting January 1st. The government also intends on cracking down on so-called chameleon carriers, a practice in which a trucking company is re-registered under a different corporate name and address with the original owners still having some control over the new carrier. It's unclear what financial impact the new rules will have on carriers, though existing training programs running 9 to 13 weeks cost $7,500 to $13,000. Drivers and carriers may be eligible for grants, but as the evolution comes, there is a cost.